How is it going, ladies and gentlemen? This is the Wolf Around, and it's great to see you here. Installing the OpenCL libraries for your GPU vendor on Linux can be a bit tricky. Each GPU vendor creates its own OpenCL implementation as a shared library, which you load at runtime using another library called the ICD Loader. I'll provide the most straightforward and concise explanation. Subscribe to the channel, join the pack, you are always welcome here. Without further ado, let's get started. ICD Loader stands for Installable Client Driver Loader. It is responsible for loading available OpenCL libraries at runtime. Each GPU vendor creates its own OpenCL implementation specific to the GPUs they manufacture. However, these implementations don't come with any header files. Instead, the Kronos Group, the developers of OpenCL, provides the OpenCL header files, essentially the function declarations for OpenCL. GPU vendors ensure their implementations follow the same declarations provided by the Kronos Group. As long as you have these function declarations, you can load a shared library at runtime and call those functions. This is where the ICD Loader comes into play, serving as the bridge between your code and the vendor's shared library. First, we'll install an application called clinfo. This tool is essential for validating your OpenCL installation. Install clinfo using apt. Now, let's run it. As you can see, no OpenCL implementation is currently installed. On this notebook, there are two GPUs, Nvidia and Intel. Neither of their OpenCL implementations is installed. In this video, we'll focus on installing Nvidia's OpenCL implementation. However, before doing that, you need to install the Nvidia GPU drivers for your system. I have already covered this in a previous video on my channel. There is a link to that video in the description. If you haven't installed your Nvidia drivers yet, go watch that video first. Installing Nvidia's OpenCL ICD Loader is as simple as installing clinfo. We'll use apt for this. Copy the package name from the Debian wiki page you see on the screen right now. I'll share the link in the video description. Notice that the installation will include its dependencies as well. Complete the installation process. Now, let's install Nvidia's OpenCL implementation. Copy the package name from the same page and install it using apt. Once again, notice that this installation will also include dependencies. Among these dependencies are OpenCL C headers and OpenCL CLHPP headers. These are the header files provided by the Kronos Group. You can also find these packages listed separately on the same page, apart from the Nvidia's OpenCL package. Let's run clinfo again. As you can see, clinfo now prints a lot of information. This means the installation was successful. It prints details about the OpenCL implementation we just installed and the GPU on my notebook. Don't be misled by the label OpenCL 3.0 CUDA. We didn't install CUDA as part of this process. That's simply the name Nvidia uses for their OpenCL implementation. You can apply what you learn in this video to other Debian-based Linux distributions. By the way, I have placed a screenshot in the bottom corner showing an example CMake configuration for using OpenCL. Unfortunately, I won't be running any example code for OpenCL in this video since I'm not planning a development-focused series for it. I'm a software engineer specializing in computer graphics, game development, GPU hardware acceleration, AI inference, and cross-platform C++ development. And I look forward to sharing more insights with you. Please like and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next one.